What's going on YouTube? In today's fantastic color grading tutorial, I'm going to be covering the basics of rendering. So we're going to be working with delivery page. Now this will be oriented for beginner viewers or maybe intermediate. Maybe you don't know something about this page, so I'm going to cover a little bit of material here. So this is delivery page. The version of DaVinci Resolve I'm working is 16.2. It's the latest one that just came out a couple days ago, or actually yesterday. So let's start it. I am working right now here with the file from raw film. It was shot on red camera. We have a guy inspecting the plane, and I already color graded. So let's talk about delivering the file. So the first thing, obviously, is the file name. Over here, you put the name of your file. Location is very self-explanatory. It's where you rendering your footage. Now, here's a few things that you need to know. For example, if you're working with an older computer, that your computer is not that fast, and you need to render some heavy lifting footage, anything 4K and above, your older hard drive may fail you when you render. It happens, especially if you have one of those 5400 drives that used in laptops a lot of times, or even some 7200 drives, regular HDDs, are just not fast enough if you're rendering heavy format, especially at a higher resolution, because we're talking about terabytes possibly of data, so they cannot keep up with that speed. So what do you need to do in order to make sure your rendering will go successful? Go to the file, and at the very bottom, you're going to see render speed. If your computer cannot keep up with a crazy amount of data that you're throwing at it, make sure to change your render speed somewhere between 10 to 5 frames. It will ensure that if you have older drive of or if there's any kind of problem, the computer will be able to write and read within the reasonable amount of time all your data. So your computer not going to hang on you. This is a very common problem among people online. I've been reading in the comments that people say rendering freezes on them. So make sure to check that. That's very important. So let's get back to the video section. Okay, so here we have format. Here you choose the format you want to render. For most people, and I'm talking about even professional filmmakers to beginner filmmakers, you only realistically going to have a couple popular choices. So number one, it's the QuickTime. You can render in H.264 or H.265. Nowadays, I highly recommend using H.265 because it's a little better quality, and you have an option to use NVIDIA encoder, meaning that if you have relatively fast graphic card, your rendering will go much faster. Again, that's all depends, you know, big chunks of it depends on how fast your hard drives are. Now, for this kind of stuff, I really recommend rendering from at least SSD to SSD. Don't render on a slower drive again because your computer may hang. If you're a PC user, you're going to see DNX HD, that's for HD resolution, or DNX HR. So this would be your higher end format. If you're an Apple user, most likely instead of this, you're going to have ProRes. And you already know all the flavors of ProRes from HQ to LT. So that's up to you what you choose. Now, these are the most common formats, especially for delivery online, such as YouTube, Vimeo, H.264 or H.265 would be your appropriate choice. Now, here you select resolution. By default, the resolution of your rendering is going to be exactly the same as resolution of your project. Here's a little thing that you need to know. You're not going to benefit by putting higher resolution in your rendering than your timeline. Always make sure that your timeline is exactly the same resolution as your source file. That way you're rendering everything and everything is appropriate. Now, here you have advanced settings, and this is where a lot of people making big mistake. And when I was a young colorist and didn't know any better, I think it was DaVinci Resolve like 8 or 9, I used to always put this to full. However, there's a few kind of interesting tricks about this. In most cases, do not change your data levels. Always leave it at auto and let DaVinci Resolve automatically figure out what is going on. In certain cases, if you're rendering out sequence or above 12-bit, you may need to put it on full resolution, I mean on full data levels, but it depends on, again, your project and the format you're rendering. If you're average user, if you're normal filmmaker, even if you're rendering high-end commercial, most likely leaving at auto will do just fine, so you don't need to tweak anything. A lot of times people ask me why when I render the footage looks milky or too dark. This is the reason why you're probably putting on video or full. So don't touch any of that. Use optimized media, use render cache. This one is a little bit tricky. When you working with DaVinci Resolve, I highly recommend using optimized media and render cache, especially if you have a lot of complex VFX going on, or if you color grading, have some kind of noise reduction, and your computer basically hangs and cannot cope with that. However, when you rendering, I don't recommend using those because it may create a little problem down the line. The versions may not match, and basically you're much better off just unchecking them to be sure that you're rendering normal and computer process whatever you've done all over again. That way everything is fine. Now, for force sizing to highest quality, force debayer to highest quality, again, if you're average user, you don't need to worry about that, so leave those as is. Tone mapping, this one is for HDR content, and most likely within the next year or so, you're not going to touch any of that because none of the online platforms can support HDR. And even some people claim that YouTube does, it does not. The HDR renders on YouTube look exactly like normal videos. So, audio. Audio is very straightforward. You have PCM and AAC. By default, I don't touch with it. I don't mess with it. I just leave as default. I'm not an audio engineer, so I don't really need to mess. However, if you have some kind of special music project, make sure to check with your audio recordist if there's a special format they want. So this one by default will give you fantastic sound, so you don't need to worry about it. On top, you have presets. I don't recommend using those presets just because, in my opinion, what I play around with them, the quality does not come out right. For example, if you're rendering for YouTube, all default settings will give you really good quality. Do not mess with it. Don't do any kind of restrictions. Those files, in particular with H.265, are going to be small in size and very high quality. And let the YouTube do its own compression. That way, you don't have to mess anything while rendering. Okay, let's move on. So if you have multiple files over here, right now I only have one file on the timeline. You can specify that if you want to render a single file. So for example, if you right click on the little square and you can select render this clip, DaVinci Resolve will only render one shot. So all you would have to do, click add to queue, select your destination and click save. So that's the drill. If you want to render entire timeline, go to the timeline, right click, and select entire timeline. So that's how you select clip versus timeline. Also, you can specify in and out points. Okay, so let me show you. Let's say I want this to be in point, so mark in, and this I want to be out point, mark out. And this little selected area will be the exactly area that DaVinci Resolve will render this for you. It can be a single clip or it can be a range of different files that you specified. Just make sure, it's very important, every single time you do some kind of adjustment, make sure to add to the queue. Because if you don't, DaVinci Resolve will not update your existing queue. For example, let's say that you add this. Let me do desktop. Let's say you selected this to be in the queue. And now, let's say for some reason I'm changing my resolution. Well, if I'm going to click start rendering, it's not going to pick up to this change. It's going to pick up on the job that's in the queue. So every single time you change anything, make sure you keep adding it to a queue. That way it's up to date, and this is exactly what DaVinci Resolve is going to render. Because I know some people have been making this mistake. They would add to queue, then they would start digging with the files, and then they would click render, and it's not going to come out what they selected. This is exactly why. Every time you add or change something, you have to add again to a queue. That way it will render up to date. So this concludes the basics of rendering. Leave a comment below if you guys want me to do a more in-depth video about different formats. I have a fantastic video coming out comparing the best format you should use for YouTube. I'm comparing the compressions and how it looks. So stay tuned for this one. It's coming out next week. All my computer specs and the equipment I have listed in the description below. Be sure to check out my Origami LUTs for multiple cameras, including Blackmagic and newly added DJI. And I'm going to see you guys next time. Take care.